Let's play Return to Monkey Island. We just get the quest from the cook to make our own mop. And so we can go to the get shop from the LeChuck's ship. And when we're able to go inside of the ship, we're able to go to the Monkey Island. And we also need disguise. We need. But before that, we have to search and clicking everything here and to try to find something else to picking up.
Remind me never to eat here again. It's amazing what you can achieve if you put your mind to it. Then you have a packet of stick-on stars. The food is more exciting when you can smell the risk.
Excellent, we found the cart. Let's see what they have. The Ale, what does the sign on the door says? Employees only. Yeah, I remember. Okay, go back. Nothing else here. Admire the mop.
Well, it's definitely a mop.
Stay away from my mop!
Active little guys, aren't they? Looks like a mugshot.
In here.
Ugh, I remember that stench as if it were yesterday.
What we have here? A seagull.
The plaque says, in memory of looming seagulls of old.
Okay, it's dead.
I think someone tried to secure a boat with this.
Nice, we get string. Maybe we can make the mop. But we need the handle. That's the main thing on the mop. Just for fun to talk with them.
Are you sure I can't persuade you to back my expedition to Monkey Island?
Let's pretend I was really considering this. What sort of pirate qualifications have you got, exactly?
I have a great sense of humor, and I like long walks on the beach.
Well, I was a director of combat operations for the British Navy, and I've written 2 books on ship-to-ship tactics.
I'm a founding member and co-director of the Red Fleet and hold records for civilian casualties from San Domingo to Venezuela.
I'm an expert in 17 forms of hand-to-hand combat, 3 of which I invented. I served with Bellamy, Teach, and Roberts before they each met an untimely end that I might have had nothing to do with.
Just so you know, this is the kind of resume we expect.
Oh.
Let's go to where we should go. Let's go to the museum. The forest area. Oh, it's open.
Hi there. Welcome to the Malay Island Museum of Pirate Lore. I'm Conrad, the curator and docent here. I also edit the Pirate Times newsletter. Here, take my business card.
Thanks?
The museum showcases the largest collection of pirate memorabilia in the Caribbean. Or on Malay Island, at the very least. The provenance of each item has been very carefully researched and fact-checked by myself and my team. Feel free to explore. And if you have any questions, just ask.
What can you tell me about this eye patch?
That's the pride of the collection. It belonged to Captain John Laney, the Pirate of 1,000 Faces. Supposedly, it had voodoo powers that would disguise him. I tried it on, though, and nothing happened.
Yeah, we need that. That is what we need.
Eye patch worn by Captain John Laney, the Pirate of a Thousand Faces. What's the story with the wanted poster?
That is the earliest known wanted poster for Captain Kate Capsize. You can tell how notorious she was by the huge number of crimes listed there. Very impressive. I got it from a collector on Fat Island.
Those are my own crimes, actually. I was pretty much public enemy number one on Fat Island at the time. I stuck Kate's picture on there so she'd get thrown in jail.
That would never work. Nobody's that clueless in real life.
You don't believe me?
It's not a question of belief.
Never mind. It's not important. That is a really big parrot. Wonder how many hands it's eaten. What do you feed it?
Thieves, mostly.
Good to know. It's a working parrot. I shouldn't bother it. What was this cinder you've got on the wall?
Oh, that. Yeah, that was an unsent love letter written by Elaine Marley while she was governor of the island.
What? Elaine?
The recipient was referred to only as Plunder Bunny.
That's me!
It was a really touching letter. Unfortunately, I put the candle too close to it.
What did it say? Tell me what she said!
Oh, you know, love letter stuff. Honestly, I don't remember a word of it, but it was touching.
Thanks a lot. Tell me about this hunk of wood.
That's an original plank from the Golden Hind, autographed by Francis Drake himself.
What's this melted lump of metal?
It used to be a mug. It was melted by some kind of acid. It was found in the Malay jail many years ago, after an incident where like 20 pirates escaped.
Hey, I did that. I had to keep pouring the grog from mug to mug because it was melting them. I had an armload of mugs and I juggled them all the way from the scum bar to the jail. Also, I could get Otis to join my crew. Not my greatest decision in retrospect.
That's a pretty wild story.
I'm telling you the truth.
I'm sure you are. But it just doesn't quite square with the official record. So it's hard to substantiate.
Substantiate? You've got an eyewitness.
Eyewitnesses are notoriously inaccurate. Human memory is plastic and suggestible.
Not yours, apparently.
No, of course not. I deal in facts.
That map looks familiar.
That's one quarter of the original map to the treasure of Big Whoop. I got it from the cartographer on Low Street. Apparently, he was somehow involved in the search for Big Whoop.
About all Wally managed to do was get kidnapped by LeChuck's henchmen.
That's not the way he tells it.
I'm just trying to help.
Thanks. I've got it under control.
God.
How on earth do you have that note?
Oh, yeah. That's very interesting. That was found tucked inside of a book at the Fat Island Library. It's the actual note left by the ghost pirate LeChuck when he kidnapped Governor Marley.
I know what it is. The lookout handed it to me just before I finished my three trials. I was crushed, but undaunted. I gathered a crew and I sailed to Monkey Island to save her. Not that she needed it, as it turned out.
Wow, man, you're really into this. I've got a role-playing group on Thursday nights.
This is absurd. It's like this whole wall is stuff from my personal adventures, but somehow I'm not even mentioned in your stories.
That's what's so great about this museum. Everyone makes their own connections with the exhibits, and it's highly personal and different for everyone.
That's not what I'm trying to say at all.
That's okay. You don't need to say anything. Just listen to what the exhibits tell you.
Fine.
Okay. What do we have here? Storeroom. Nothing much here. Card and pirate food.
It's cracker mix. Some assembly required.
Let's see what... What's the card have? Penguins, mushroom, hardy-cardies. God damn it. Let's talk with him.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood.
No kidding? Wow! Are you named after Guybrush Threepwood?
I guess you could say that.
Nice.
I'm going to find the legendary secret of Monkey Island.
Oh, that's excellent! Super retro! If you need a place to display it, I know a convenient museum.
Your museum is quaint.
Thanks. It's been a personal passion of mine. I'm nuts about old-timey pirate stuff.
Old-timey?
Being around it really makes you feel like you're a part of something. Doesn't it?
I am part of something.
Exactly.
Are any of these things valuable?
The security parrot isn't just here to look piratey. John Laney's eye patch is irreplaceable. It's the highlight of the collection. Amazingly, I got it at a yard sale. They didn't know what they had.
Do you have maps of the forest here?
No, that's not really what we do. Try the map shop in town?
Tell me about that newsletter of yours.
The Pirate Times. We publish pirate news, pirate stories, pirate poetry, all things piratey, really.
I see you wear a peg leg, despite having both of your original legs.
Just part of the docent's outfit, for the tourists. Kids always want to try it on.
That's charming and creepy at the same time.
This is a museum for people who think attacking ships and murdering the crew for profit sounds fun.
Touché. We'll have a look around.
Please do.
Don't get anything from him. How we progress here?
It's a working parrot. I shouldn't bother it.
Yeah, here.
Is this a left hook or a right hook?
That once belonged to the dread pirate Meat Hook. Supposedly he was ambidextrous. Also, he used to live right here, on Melee.
Where he is now. Hey, of course.
Well, the numbers are a little clearer, but still too tiny to read.
That thing. Not able to do the key. Oh, sweet. Ooh. Should we try this magical book, hint book? Yeah. How do I get the map? How do I join the Let's Up without being recognized? I know that. Map. I say mob. I mean, how can I find the mob handle tree? Maybe there is a shop in town that can help you find things. Okay, let's go to the voodoo lady.
Any other mystical advice or information for me?
No.
How does dark magic work?
Runes, chemicals, the power of secrets. I am no expert. It's too sterile for my tastes. I like things messy and theatrical.
Is dark magic powerful?
Powerful, yes, it can be. But dangerous. If the badger chews his own tail, soon there is no more badger.
You like that metaphor a lot, don't you?
It has many uses.
Can dark magic get me to Monkey Island?
No.
Nuts. Where can I get my hands on some dark magic?
Dark magic is not your path, Guybrush Threepwood.
I'll get back to browsing the shop.
Act fast. Supplies are limited.
She don't have anything for us. Nothing here. Do you have anything?
Hey, Wally. I'm looking for a tree to make a stupid mop from. Have you got a map for that?
So the cook has sent you on one of his spiritual journeys? been a while since I made one of those mop tree maps. What kind of tree is it again?
I don't know. A wood one?
That's okay. Just bring me a sliver of the wood and I can work it out from there. I'm that good.
Oh.
Bye. Okay.
Bye. Let's go to the cook. Maybe we can get a little bit from his mop. Yes, now I know. He used a knife to get the slice of the mop. Over here. Bye bye. And then we use the this one.
Stay away from my mop!
Well, you look like the health inspector tasted your stew. Or you did.
Worse! Marlin is here!
Who?
The customer I have nightmares about. He's the only importer of yak fat on the island, so I need to keep him happy, but he makes that impossible. Today he wants me to make him a dish that he ate last week at some kind of event at the governor's mansion. But of course he doesn't remember what it's called or know what's in it or even remember what color it was. He says he thinks it has ingredients in it. I don't have the slightest idea what to make.
If I brought you a recipe, could you make it?
Of course. I'm a cook. See the hat?
Oh, look behind you, a three-headed monkey.
I do know a great stew recipe for monkey heads. But I can't think about that right now.
We need to distract the cook so we can get the slice of the mop. So we can get the mop sample for the Wally, and so he can make the map for us. And I think this is not going to be easy.
Where did he say he had the dish he wants you to make?
At the governor's mansion. It's probably some exotic, weird-tasting thing from a swanky cookbook.
Yeah. The library. And we need the cookbook.
I'll see what I can find out.
Thanks.
Oh, there he is.
Hi.
Are you my waiter? I want the excellent dish I had at the governor's mansion last week. I don't know what it's called, but it was sort of, you know, a hot food.
Yeah, but I'm not...
It had ingredients in it or something.
I'm not your waiter.
I already told your incompetent cook this, but he still hasn't brought me my dinner.
No, it's this one. The ingredients.
It's a cookbook. It has 4 stars, but it looks like they're for difficulty. Can I borrow a book?
Yeah, after hearing those words, I guess that it would take a long time to solve this riddle. And it did. I had to open the hint book a few times. I also found that the Glocksmith Parrot's cookies can be exchanged for cookie books. After a little thought, the frog can give forgiveness to Carla, but I couldn't get the forgiveness done right after many tries. But after finding a few keys presses on Carla's poster in the harbor and on the Carla's statue, I was able to give the frog and finally get the cookbook from
this
her.
This is for you.
Dear Carla, I'm impressed, Guybrush. Surprisingly thoughtful. Considering it's you, I'm strangely moved to forgive you for losing my book. And I'll treasure this frog as a memento of the time you did something right.
Nice. Thank you.
Can I borrow this cookbook?
You cook like a cow.
That's why I need the cookbook.
Oh, all right. I was upset after you lost the last one, but you seem genuinely sorry, so I guess I'll give you another chance.
Thanks. I won't let you down. I'll definitely return this.
Yes. We have the cookbook.
It's a cookbook. It has 4 stars, but it looks like they're for difficulty.
Okay. Now, next game, we got to give the cookbook for the cook. And let's see, can we have the piece of the, what's this, the mop? So we can get the map for the forest one from Wally. Then we can make the mop. I don't know how we can get the eye patch, but well, it's next time. Have a good day. Bye.